Om Yogis, welcome to a practice today that hopes to be movement therapy for us. Start in a seated position and just connect to your breath, filling up as you inhale, filling the body with breath. And as you exhale, just get this sense of arrival. You're here. You made it. You've arrived. You have arrived in a practice for those days where you might not want to talk, or maybe you don't want to hear it. You know, you just want to be on your mat and just move some energy. We don't need a theme. We're just going to move and see what happens. So coming into Sukhasana, cross-leg position when you're ready. Interlace your fingers and stretch your chest. And as you exhale, bow forward as best you can. And once you're in that forward fold, just wiggle a little side to side. And then inhale, come on up. And let's take that into a twist. So just revolve through your ribs, keeping your hips nice and rooted, spinning open through your upper chest, twisting one way. Coming back to center and twisting the other way. Coming back to center, let's take some seated cat-cows. So just bring your hands to your knees, and as you inhale, open your chest. As you exhale, round the back, pull the belly in towards the spine. Doing this on your own. Couple of times, and then coming back to center when you're ready, drop onto one hand and just side stretch over. Coming back to center, same thing on the other side, side stretching. Coming back to center, switch the cross of your legs so you're crossed, the legs are crossed the weird way. And let's interlace the fingers the weird way now and stretch and open the chest as you inhale. Exhale, bow forward, wiggle a little side to side. Inhale, come back on up. Release the arms and take that into a twist. Nice easy twist here, revolve through your ribs, keep your hips rooted, spin your upper chest open. Coming back to center, twisting the other way. Coming back to center, take a few seated cat-cows here. And then drop onto one hand, side stretch over. And then comes back to center, over to the other side on that side stretch. Whichever hand is in the air, keep the same hip, rooted to the ground. So you feel that stretch coming into the waist. Back to center when you're ready. And then come onto all fours and come into cat-cow. Melting the chest as you gaze forward. Exhaling, rounding the back. And do a few of these on your own. Lovely. Let's come back to center and drop down to Anahatasana. With your arms wide, so your fingers come to the corners of your mat. Your knees stay over your hips. You're melting the chest down towards the floor and squeezing into the outer arms. Lovely. Come out of that. And come into plank position. In plank position, your belly is lifting, your tailbone is moving down towards your heels, your legs are strong, your hands are over your shoulders. And we're going to bend the knee of one leg until it lightly touches the ground. And then extend it back to plank and swap it over. So bend the knee of the other leg, lightly touch the ground, back to plank. Bending one knee at a time to lightly touch the ground and back to plank a few more times on your own. Coming back to center when you're ready, press back, downward facing dog. And when you're in your downward facing dog, narrow the dog. So bring your hands a little more towards your feet or your feet a little more towards your hands. And just take a twist here, bring the opposite hand to the opposite calf. Back to center when you're ready, then over to the other side, twisting, opening, arriving. Bring yourself back to plank when you're ready. Come to center first, then come to plank. Bring both knees to lightly touch the ground now, and then re-extend to plank. Both knees come down, re-extend. Then when you're ready, downward facing dog. Back to plank. This time both knees are going to lightly touch the ground. Then we come back to plank. Then we round the upper back. And then we come back to plank. Both knees to the ground. Back to plank. Round the upper back. Back to plank. Last time, both knees lightly touch. Plank. Round the upper back. Back to plank. And then push back, downward facing dog. Let's walk the hands back to the feet. So you're folding here, interlace your fingers, stretch it out, squeeze and wiggle. Release your hands, hang for a moment, gently nod the head yes, shake the head no, release any tension in the neck. Bend your knees, keep your head and your shoulders heavy as you roll up through your spine, coming to stand. And then meeting at the top of the mat with the feet together. You know, sometimes for me, I just need to pipe down. I need to get out of my head and get into my body and just be moved by my body and the music and my breath. And for me, this is why on those particular days, yoga in itself is a kind of movement therapy. Of course it is. So let's take a moment, bringing the hands to the heart, setting an intention now that this practice have a therapeutic impact upon our lives. Gorgeous. And then inhale, lift your arms. Exhale, fold on in. Inhale, halfway rise. Exhale, fold on in. Inhale, bring yourself back to plank. And as you exhale, lower to the floor, knees, chest, chin, chaturanga, however it works for you today. Inhale, cobra, baby cobra. Use the strength in your back to lift your chest. And as you exhale, press back, downward facing dog. Let's lift one leg, three-legged dog. Stretching and opening in whatever way feels good for your body today. Then drop that leg down, lift the other leg. And then drop that down back to downward facing dog. Pressing into your hands and feet evenly. Let the pose be symmetrical, let the breath be a bit deep. And then drop down for a moment, child's pose. Again, let yourself arrive. Taking a moment as we bow to the practice that we are about to do. This practice of yoga that is movement therapy for us all. Okay, from child's pose, let's come to downward facing dog and lift your right leg as you inhale, and as you exhale, step your right leg to the little finger side of your right hand, and just take a moment here in this lunge. When you're ready, step back to downward facing dog. The left leg is lifting now. And we step the left leg to the little finger side of the left hand, taking a moment to lunge here on the other side. Beautiful, back to downward facing dog. Lift the right leg as you inhale. Step it forward to the little finger side of the right hand as you exhale. Inhale in that lunge. And exhale back to dog. Inhale, left leg lifts. As you exhale, bring it forward to the little finger side of the left hand. Take a deep inhale in the lunge and exhale back to dog. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, step it forward. Inhale, lunge. And exhale back to dog. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, step it forward. Inhale, lunge. Exhale, downward facing dog. Let's step, walk, or jump to the top of the mat. And as you inhale, come to a halfway rise. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, stand up, look at your thumbs. Exhale, hands to heart. Shake out your hands now, shake out your whole body. And next we're going to do a breath of joy. So as you inhale, the arms come forward. As you exhale, the arms come out, shoulder height. As you inhale, raise them up. And as you exhale, swing forward and fold, bending the knees. Inhale, come on up, arms forward. Exhale out. Inhale up. Exhale, swing. Inhale forward. Exhale out. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. Inhale forward, exhale out, up and fold. Forward, out, up, fold. Forward, out, up, fold. Forward, out, up, and fold. Just stay in the fold now, lovelies. Interlace your hands now the weird way. And take a moment here. Wiggle out any tension. Then release the hands, bend the knees, and roll slowly up through your spine. Head and shoulders come up last. Let's inhale, lift the arms. Exhale, fold on in. Inhale, halfway rise. Exhale, fold a little deeper. Inhale, plank position. Exhale, lower to the floor. Inhale, cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. Stay in dog or drop to child's pose if you need a little bit of a rest. And then everybody comes back to dog. And we're going to lift the right leg as we inhale. And as we exhale, we're going to step that right leg to the outer right hand, taking a moment in the lunge position. We've done this 3 times before, so the body's really used to this now. Now we're going to take the left hand to the floor, peel the right arm open and come into a twist here. Breathing and opening. When you're ready, bring your hands back to the mat and step back, downward facing dog. The left leg lifts. And we step the left leg forward to the outside of the hand. Take a moment. Then come into that twist on the other side. Reaching the arms away from one another. Breathing and opening. Back to downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the left leg. Exhale, step it forward to the outer hand. Sorry, the right leg. Right leg to the outer hand. Lunge here as you inhale. As you exhale, bring your left hand to the floor, peel it open, and as you inhale, twist. Exhale, step back to downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg this time lifts. Exhale, step forward. Inhale, lunge. Exhale, plant the hand, and as you inhale, peel open and twist. Exhale, downward facing dog. Right leg lifts as you inhale. Exhale, step it forward. Inhale, lunge. Exhale, hand comes to the floor. Inhale, peel it open and twist. Exhale, downward facing dog. Left leg lifts. Step it forward on the exhale. Lunge on the inhale. Exhale, bring the hands to the floor. Inhale, peel it open, twisting. And exhale, downward facing dog. Last round, right leg lifts. Exhale, bring it forward. Inhale, lunge. Exhale, peel it open. Inhale in the twist. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, step it forward. Inhale, lunge. Exhale, peel it open. Inhale, twist. And exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful. Let's step, walk, or jump to the top of the mat. And inhale to a halfway rise. Exhale, fold on in. Inhale, stand up, look at your thumbs. Tailbone lowers towards the ground. And exhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, the arms lift. Exhale, fold on in. Inhale, halfway rise. Exhale, fold a little deeper. Inhale, plank position. Exhale, lower to the floor. Inhale, cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. Now step your right leg to the thumb side of your hand. And rise your body up so you are just hovering above the thigh, sending the arms back behind you in a high lunge. Create a nice long line with your body. Now squeeze your arms more towards one another and send your heart forward. And stay put now in the lower body, but just send the arms forward so they line up with the ears. Nice long diagonal line from the fingers all the way to the heel. Pushing into your back heel, create that long line, make it longer, right up into your fingertips. And then when you're ready, standing up, crescent lunge. Take your crescent lunge into a twist by bringing your left hand to the floor. And you can stay here or you can roll to the outer edge of your left foot and shift your right foot to halfway along your mat for an easy Vashastasana. You can stay here or you can take full Vashastasana, pushing your hips skywards. Now turn this into a regular plank. Lower to your forearms, forearm plank. Walk your feet in, dolphin. Walk them back to forearm plank. And then come back into dolphin. And at this point, your arms will be saying child's pose, child's pose. So let's follow the arms into child's pose. And breathe here. From child's pose, let's come into hero. So just sitting back to your heels. Bring your hands behind your head, your elbows go wide and reach back behind you. And as you inhale, twist a little to the left. Exhale, twist a little to the right. You can go as slowly or quickly as you like here. Sometimes it's good to kind of pump the breath. Sometimes not. It's your class, your movement therapy. Follow your body to where it wants to go. coming back to center when you're ready. Let's take Kapalabhati breath. So short, sharp exhale out of the nose as the belly pulls in. Deep inhalation. Plant your hands, step back, downward facing dog. Let's step, walk, or jump to the top of the mat. As you inhale, come halfway, rise. And as you exhale, fold on in. Inhale, stand up, reach up, look at your thumbs, and exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Inhale, now the arms lift. Exhale, we fold on in. Inhale, halfway rise. Exhale, fold a little deeper. Come back to plank on your inhale. And as you exhale, lower the body to the floor. Inhale, cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. Let's step the left leg to the thumb side of your hand. And rise your body up into a high lunge, but you're just hovering above the thigh. Sending the arms back behind you. So pitching the body forwards, taking the legs back, pushing into that back heel. Squeeze your arms towards each other to send the heart a little more forward. Now stay put in the lower body, but just send the arms in line with the ears. So you're stretching long. Pushing into that back heel, try to create a nice long line from the heel to the fingertips. Then when you're ready, stand all the way up, crescent lunge. Let's take that into a twist by bringing the opposite hand to the floor. So I think that would be your right hand. And stay here. Or roll to the outer edge of your left foot and shift the right foot to halfway along your mat for easy Vashistasana. If I've got my left and right muddled up, I'm so sorry. And you can stay here or you can take full Vashistasana, pushing your hips skywards. Beautiful. Turn this into a regular plank. And then lower to your forearms, forearm plank. From forearm plank, we come into dolphin for a couple of breaths. And then back into forearm plank. And then back into dolphin. Until eventually the arms say child's pose. So let's come into child's pose. And in child's pose, let's take the arms over to the left as you drop into the right side of the hip for a side stretch here. Coming back to center when you're ready. Switching sides. Pushing back, back to center, and then pushing back, downward facing dog. From downward facing dog, let's step, walk or jump to the top of the mat. When you get there, inhale for a halfway rise and exhale, fold on in. Let's inhale, stand on up, reach up, look at your thumbs, and exhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, your arms lift, and exhale, let's fold on in. Inhale, halfway rise, and exhale, fold a little deeper. Inhaling back to plank. Let's exhale, lower to the floor. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathing in dog. Okay, let's step the right leg to the right thumb now. Bring yourself all the way up, crescent pose, lifting your lower belly skywards as you lift your arms, dropping your tailbone down. Now bring your hands to shoulder height in a nice wide T shape. And twist here so your right hand comes towards the back of the mat and your left arm comes towards the top of the mat. So it's like you're being stretched in opposite directions through your arms and your hips stay as neutral as possible. Take a breath here and then when you're ready, windmill the arms back to the mat and meet me in downward facing dog. Let's step the left leg forward, coming up to crescent pose on the inhale. Lifting your lower belly skywards as you drop through the tailbone and lift the arms. Now bringing your hands to shoulder height, nice wide T, and twist through the waist, the hips stay as neutral as possible. Take a breath here, and then windmill the arms down, meet me in dog. Step the right foot forward to the thumb. Rise up on the inhale for crescent pose. As you exhale, hands come into a nice wide T. Twisting when you're ready. Exhale again as you twist. Take an inhale in the twist. And then exhale, windmill the arms down, downward facing dog. Left leg comes forward. Inhale, rise up, crescent pose. As you exhale, wide T. Take an inhale here, and as you exhale, twist. Try to keep your balance, try to keep your hips as neutral as possible. Take an inhale in the twist. And then windmill the arms back to the mat. Meet me in downward facing dog. Let's come to the top of the mat, bring the feet together and come into a very low chair pose. Stay low, bring your elbows to your knees. Your hands come to prayer at your heart and we're just going to twist, bringing your elbow to your outer thigh. Go whichever way you like. Try to keep your knees together and lined up. Let your head be neutral, your palms press to create a nice revolve in the chest. Come back to center when you're ready. And we're just going to repeat that on the other side. Come back to center when you're ready. Folding forward, release that pressure on the thighs, but separate your feet to the outer edges of your mat. Bringing your heels in and your toes out, let's come into Malasana yogic squat. Let's bring that Malasana into a twist. So use the lever of your base arm against the leg and open your top arm. And twisting here. Bringing yourself back to center when you're ready. Use the arms against the leg to twist the other way. Just like the outer arm against the inner leg. Then come back to center. And bring this Malasana down so you're staying in the pose, but you're sitting down now. And turn, roll your thighs open in this seated Malasana. So your inner thighs kind of are open to the ceiling as near enough as possible. It won't be completely to the ceiling. And now let's do that twist on that side this way. So use your arm against your leg to twist your body open. One way. Then back to center. And then twisting the other way. Flexing the feet. Resting the feet on the outer edges, using the arm against the leg to deepen the twist. When you're ready, come back to center, bring the feet together, knees go wide, Baddha Konasana. Hold on to your feet or your ankles or your toes, and let's do some Sufi rolls here. So just roll through your belly. Make little circles to begin with and see if they naturally want to get bigger and bigger, or just stay little today. It's fine. Change the direction of your circles when you're ready. Slowly bring that back to stillness, coming into Sukhasana, cross-legged. We'll take Kapalabhati here, breath of fire. This breath stimulates every tissue in the body. The vital nerve current along the spine is stimulated through the solar plexus and the scooping of the sacrum as you breathe out. So short, sharp exhale out of the nose as you pull the belly in. Breathe deeply. And let's come into cat-cow. So come on to all fours, sorry lovely. Taking cat-cow, we activate the nerve ganglia along the entire spine. As we inhale, open the chest, bringing the top of the head sort of in the same direction as the tailbone towards one another, and then exhale, rounding the spine, bringing them towards one another again, but this time in front of you. So feel that sort of cranial sacral dance that's going on here. Breathing deep. Then coming back to center when you're ready and press back downward facing dog. Downward facing dog stretches and spreads the whole of the back body so the currents of energy can really flow, and this is where we're going today. We just want to move the energy in the body. And from downward facing dog, let's bring the right foot forward now into a low lunge. Let your hips drop forward as your lower belly lifts. And you can interlace your hands in front of you now, pressing your palms against your thigh to accentuate the feeling of simultaneously dipping the ball of the pelvis whilst lifting the frontal hip bones and the belly up. Like a push me, pull you. And now reach the arms up and slightly back, curling your chest open from here. Release that when you're ready and press back, downward facing dog. Let's do exactly the same thing on the other side. So bring your left foot forward. Allow the hips to drop as the lower belly lifts. Place the hands against the thigh. Push into the hands to lift and open the chest. As you dip the ball of the pelvis and lift the frontal hip bones so the tailbone can scoop low, reach the arms up and slightly back, curling your chest open. And again, have that feeling, I've arrived. It's good to be here. It's good to be here. And plant your hands when you're ready and press back, downward facing dog. From downward facing dog, now let's bring the right leg forwards and come into dragon pose. We'll just take a good sort of 10 breaths here now. Say we're about there now, so you can either choose to stay in dragon or you can ground your back foot to 45 degrees, gently lift your back knee and start to snuggle your shoulder under your front leg as best you can. And you can stay here with the hands planted and the shoulders snuggled. Or if you want, you can come into an aeroplane lunge by just lifting your arms out to the sides. Breathing here, send the gaze forward. And fly. I realize it doesn't feel like flying. So let's come out of that and back to downward facing dog. Bringing your left leg forwards now, I believe, for dragon pose. Take a good 10 breaths or so here. Lovely. And you can stay here or you can ground your back foot to that 45 degree angle. Lift your back knee and start to work to snuggle your shoulder under your front leg. And then from here, you can lift the arms wide for that aeroplane lunge pose. And then come out of that and meet me in downward facing dog. And from downward facing dog, we're going to come into half Hanumanasana, half splits. So we're reversing the lunge. So your front leg is going to be straight and you're going to rest on the back knee. Hello, I haven't told us to put a block down yet. Okay, a block down? My mind is gone. Okay, let's bring the right leg forwards, the left leg forward, right leg forward, sorry. Okay, let's get it together. And let's come into half Hanumanasana on that side. So your right leg will be out in front of you and you're sitting back towards the left heel. And you can fold over your straight leg. Try to keep your pelvis as neutral as possible. And if you have loads of sensation, you can stay here. If you're feeling really open today, you might want to grab a couple of blocks and do a little mini wiggle towards splits, your version of it today. Go slowly, use your hands to take your weight, wiggling your front heel forwards and your back knee back until you reach a nice, intense, but safe stretch for you today. And you can kind of pop yourself onto the blocks. But do bear in mind that you will need to escape the pose at some point, so don't overdo it, don't overstretch it. Once you find your version of splits today, if possible, sit yourself up and smile hard. Breathe deep. Now to come out, we support the weight with the hands and drag your front foot back towards you. And then you can vinyasa to dog or go straight back to downward facing dog. Stretch it out. Let's switch sides. So we're going to come into half Hanumanasana on the other side. So I believe it's your left leg coming forward this time, but you'll know it because you've just done the splits on one side. So it's the other way. Sit back to your back heel or all the way to the floor if that's appropriate for you and start to fold over your front leg. And you can stay here. If you've got loads of sensation, this is where you should be. Stay here. If you want to grab a couple of blocks and do your little mini wiggle towards splits or into splits, using your hands to take your weight, wiggle your front heel forwards, your back knee back, until you're in a really good, intense, but very safe stretch, knowing that you can get yourself out of it again. And propping yourself up on blocks is always an option, but don't overdo it. And once you reach your maximum stretch, if possible, sit yourself up and smile. Again, you have arrived, and all these positions that we arrive in through this beautiful practice. It makes me feel lucky. you're practicing with other people, make sure you smile at everyone before you gently start to come out, supporting your weight, dragging your front foot back towards you, taking a vinyasa if you want one, or come straight to downward facing dog. From downward facing dog, we're going to bring the body forwards and come onto the knees for some half camels. So you could actually sit straight back actually onto your heels. Hold one ankle. Let's do it this way. Let's sit back onto the heels. So you're kneeling. Hold one ankle and then rise your hips up, rise your body up and open it up from here for a half camel. Extend your free arm if this feels okay. And then bring the whole thing down again. So drop down, sit down, swap sides, open it up the other side. And try to, you know, enjoy it. Try to find whatever space there is there today. As you alternate in your own time, left to right side. Little half camel dance here. If you want a full camel today, you can feel really welcome to do a couple of those now or stay with your half camel dance. And then when you're ready, sit back to your heels, take a moment, breathe deep. And then drop your body forwards, come into child's pose. Let yourself ground for a moment. From child's pose, let's come back to sit upon the heels and drop to your left hip, bringing your right leg over your left leg for a half spinal twist. You're twisting towards your raised knee. And breathing deep here. With every exhalation, you can attempt to increase your twist by just wringing out your lower belly as best you can. Bring yourself back to center when you're ready. Come to sit on your heels again. Drop to the other side, the other hip, and take that twist on the other side. Back to center when you're ready. I almost lost myself then in this music. Let's come to a crouching position and just take a moment to see how crow feels today. So if you want an arm balance. If you don't, you can feel really welcome just to take another child's pose. It's your practice, it's your therapy, your movement, your yoga. Gorgeous. And then from wherever you are, let's come to seated, bringing the feet together, the knees wide, Baddha Konasana. Hook onto your toes, press your thighs with your elbows to open your inner thighs and gently start to melt your body forwards. Coming out of that when you're ready. Gently lean the body weight back, engage your belly, lift your legs, Navasana. Breathe deep. Let's take half Navasana. And then slowly lower the whole body to the floor. Now let's take thread the needle or recline pigeon on one side. So maybe let's bring the right foot to the top of the left knee. You can thread the arms if you want, or you can just lie here, whatever's good for your body. Have some flexion in the feet to protect the knees. Breathing deep here. When you're ready, let's swap that over. Reclined pigeon on the other side. And then when you're ready, release that. Come into happy baby. Let's take a few moments here. Try to keep your tailbone anchored towards the floor. Let your breath travel all the way up into your chest. Sides of the neck are long, jaw is relaxed, face is relaxed. From happy baby, let's release that. Hug your knees in towards your chest and just let them fall to your left for a supine twist. Bringing them back to center, go over to the right, supine twist on the other side. Now I start to move these twists side to side. Engage your core. Deepen your breath.
fitiava quani mamo zimi va chi fa ma funzo zara kuti chiama fana poco a bisimanunzo zimba mila.
Lovely, then come out of that, come to center. Lift your arms, lift your legs, and just shake out your arms and legs for a moment. And shuffle yourself when you're finished doing that. You can finish that and then shuffle yourself to the front of your mat. Because we're going to do shoulder stand and plow if you guys want to. If not, if you don't want a shoulder stand, just lift your legs towards the ceiling and hold the backs of your thighs for a variation of Vaparita Karani, legs up the wall or legs against your hands. If you're coming into shoulder stand, come on up when you're ready. We'll take about 10 breaths here. From shoulder stand, you can drop your legs back to plow position. Support your back as you go and keep supporting your back until your feet touch the ground behind you. If they don't touch the ground, keep your hands to your hips. If they do touch the ground, you can interlace the hands for the full pose. And breathe here. If you're just holding your legs up and you're not in shoulder stand, you can stay here. Just enjoy it. Let your back spread against the mat. And then from plow or from legs up, just legs up and holding them, you can make bring the palms of your hands to the floor, engage your belly, engage your pelvic floor, and slowly use your hands as brakes as you bring the legs back to the floor. Slowly, slowly, no jolting. Nice and slowly, nice and controlled. And once you reach the floor, slide your hands under your hips with the palms down. Push into your forearms and elbows. Lift your chest. Roll the shoulders back so you open the chest. Let the head fall backwards. Fish pose. Legs can be in any position that affords you comfort. Breathing deep here, really using this pose to open your lungs and breathe to your fullest capacity. When you're ready, bring yourself out of that and back to the floor. Interlace your hands behind your head, and lift your head with the strength of your arms, dropping the weight of your head back into your arms. Clearly, I'm ready for bed, but not yet. Still a few more poses to go. Let yourself relax. Come back into happy baby. Or you can just hug the knees in towards the chest if that feels good for the body. Beautiful. That's Hug one of your knees in towards your chest. Let the other one extend out, the other leg extend down to the bottom of your mat, and just circle your foot a few times, one way and then the other way. Now that leg that's hugged in, let's bring it into tree pose, lying on the back. You can prop this with blocks if you need to. Beautiful, then hug that knee back in and take it across the body for a twist here. Gorgeous. Coming back to center when you're ready. Hug the other knee in once you reach center and let the opposite leg reach down towards the mat. And circle your foot again on the other side, one way and then the other. So you should be working on the other foot now. And then when you're ready, bring the leg that's hugged in towards the knee, bring it into a tree position, prop it if you need to, and just relax here for a few moments. Harp noise is the noise that your lower back makes with this little sequence, really nice on the lower back. So we're gonna get that tree leg, hug it back in, and take it across the body for a twist on the other side now, letting your back melt and open and enjoy. Coming out of that when you're ready. Bringing both knees to center. And just again, let's drop them side to side. And you can drop them and stay, or you can just keep moving them side to side, whatever feels good for your body at this point. When you're ready, come back to center. Let's take reclined pigeon again. This time, bring your bottom foot to the mat. Keep the shape with your legs as best you can, and just take that into a twist. So the sole of your raised foot comes to the floor. We're twisting it out here, and relax here. come out of that when you're ready. Back to center and swap the legs for reclined pigeon on the other side. Keep the shape of the legs as you drop the bottom foot towards the floor and bring that shape into a twist as the sole of the raised foot comes to the floor. Once you find the floor, relax, 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 relax. The end of your practice today, you can arrive one more time and just feel yourself, you know, it's great to be here. Doing some smooth moves with the body, taking some different shapes to really let our energy move. Once had it described to me this way: when you do asana, when you make the shapes in a yoga practice, it's like a plumber that coming in and flushing the pipes with water. The energy can move in different ways, and any blockages just kind of move through us, clears us right out. Coming back to center when you're ready. Take a moment, just hug the knees in. Separate your knees as you circle them one way and then the other. As you flush the body out through this beautiful therapeutic practice. You know, I love to do a theme. I love a theme. There's so many themes that we can do, but we don't really need them. We don't really need them. You just need to move sometimes and just be in the body. Be grateful for the practice. And let ourselves arrive, let ourselves come back to ourselves. Taking a moment where we just sort of say, you know, ah, here I am. Hello. Hello again. When you're ready, bring yourself to Shavasana, making sure that you'll be warm enough for the next 10 minutes or so. Make sure your arms and legs, plenty of room to spread out. Make sure your shoulder blades and your sacrum have really nice contact with the floor, that your neck is relaxed, your jaw is relaxed, your face is relaxed. And then only one more thing to do, and that is to relax. Relax. Relax and enjoy. Okay, lovelies, let's begin to deepen the breath. And take whatever stretch your body needs. Maybe hugging your knees in towards your chest, take a nice stretch for the back body. Then roll yourself to one side and just stay here for a few moments. At the completion of a practice for those days where you don't want to talk or you don't want to hear it or you don't need a theme, you just want to be on your mat and move some energy. And you have done that, so well done. Bring yourself back to seated, knowing that you're different somehow now. Bringing your hands to your heart center. And thank you for joining me for this practice. I hope sincerely that it has been therapeutic. It will be therapeutic for your life. With so much love. Namaste.